first what I can do in the stock setup or the setup that I started with. It has a ton of torque, but loves to light up the tires. I'm gonna start off in the medium setting and then we'll bump it up to the high power. Much fun. Honestly, that's like a perfect amount of power. It has the torque to break it loose and do donuts. We'll bump it up to high power. It has so much torque, I can barely touch the throttle and it pulls my head back. Is awesome. I love it. It doesn't get any better than that. That's why I almost want to keep it with this sprocket because it lights the tires up. I think it'll do over 60 in this current setup. This is the best thing that I have for sure. Like I said before, if you want to build a similar car, shout out to ElectRO & Co. You can get their whole kit identical to do the same thing as I did here. It'll be linked below. Definitely check them out if you want to build anything electric. I guess now we'll do some speed runs from the low, medium, high, see what we can get it to, and then we'll change out this sprocket. All right, so I ordered the three sprockets. This obviously the highest speed. This I think will be the best mid-range. 47 on there now, I think it's a 54 for the max speed, which is a 40. So I think with the 40, we should be at almost 100 miles an hour, which we'll see here in a minute. I'm gonna start with the 54. We're gonna see what the top speed is in the max power, and we'll see what we can get this thing up to. Just gonna use my speedometer app right here. Earlier when I was doing the donuts, I pulled it back in. The wires were on fire. Look into some beefier wiring or a whole custom battery setup because it kind of melted the connectors. Probably not too good. And we'll see how fast we can get this up to in the low power.
I'm gonna start in low power. I'm gonna set my speedometer.
Picks up fast and then it tapers off. That's kind of when I know I'm pretty much not going any faster.
So based on this, it says 21. That doesn't really make sense. We'll have to run it again and see what the low is.
So on the low power, I just held my phone the whole time. We hit 51, put up the medium and see what that does.
I think until I go in the max, it's just the torque getting to the same speed.
Yeah, so I think, since I don't know why I didn't think about this before, but hit 51 again, it just increases the torque.
All right, we'll bump it up to 3.
Power 3 just has instant torque, still done. I did about 53. We'll go swap it out for the next sprocket and see what we can get it up to.
Actually staying pretty cool for it being like 90 degrees today. Doesn't like the burnouts and drifting for 10 minutes. The sprockets, I already pre-cut the chain, so it's ready to go for each sprocket.
All right, quick and easy. We're back in business.
All right, leave your guesses down below. How much faster you think this 47 compared to the 54.2 sprocket's gonna be? I'm gonna say this will do 73.
Also, if you guys are new here and you missed the first video of building this thing from start to finish, I'll leave it linked below. I haven't seen an e-kart like this before on YouTube, so if you wanna see more videos like this one, e-kart builds, I have a lot of videos planned with this thing. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss those. See what we can get it up to.
It's like driving a lowered car, scrape on everything. Since now I know it doesn't make a difference besides the torque, I'm just gonna put it in the medium mode and then we'll bump it up to high power. This speedometer's off, I have to calibrate it to the wheel size and stuff, so don't pay attention to it saying like 100 something right now. Be all good to go. says 58.8. Let me do another run. I'll put it in max. Oh, actually, I was in low. Medium. Do another run and see what we can do. That was almost 60, 59.3. We'll bump it up to high. I think my predictions were a little off.
Yeah, we're still at 60, so we'll swap it out. See how much of a difference going down 70th will do.
I think the speedometer is 7 or 8 off on what the phone was saying while I was holding it. Tires are so sticky, it just sprays up rocks at you the whole time when you're turning and ripping around. Wasn't sure with the sprocket setup what I was going to be able to. I really thought I'd be able to get pretty close to 100 miles an hour with the 40. But if this 47 is at 60, I don't know if 7 teeth lower is going to really get me there. So I knew I should have ordered, like, I think the lowest tooth I can get is a 23. I think once I'm done here, I'm going to order that up because I know it's possible with this setup, get pretty close to or over 100 with a 23. Boom. It's actually pretty easy to swap this out now that I have everything set up, ready to go. This thing's so small. I really want to build another 2 more of these and get a little track, go to an empty parking lot, get some barriers, like those cart barriers, and make a full track that I can change. Or if I can get the in at one of those indoor cart places and be able to rent it out for the day, that would be ideal. See what the 40 can do.
All right, quickly, before you see the top speed of the cart, I want to thank the sponsor of this video, Hemimoto, which hooked it up with some parts for my Surron. From the pegs to the dropper peg mount to then the brace in between, these three things are crucial if you have a Surron. You can mount it onto their mount and it drops the foot peg down for taller riders like myself. They'll just make the bike a lot more comfortable and make it feel like a bigger bike. Then paired up with their foot peg, which is pretty much double the size as your stock Surron peg. This process is really easy. Take off the two bolts, take off the peg mount. I'll take the new Hemimoto peg dropper. It's the same hardware, bolted back up on here. Bolt it on, then take your stock mount, mount it up to the Hemimoto mount. Peg mount on, slide the peg in, flip the pin, and then you're good to go. You need to have this foot peg brace, otherwise you could have some flex in here. The bracket could potentially snap. So once you put the brace in place, it eliminates that flex and any worry for this potentially snapping. The left side mounted up, good to go, and we can finally test this thing out. These bigger foot pegs are so much better. The bike's definitely gonna be a lot more comfortable now that the pegs are dropped down like an inch or two.
The lower mounts are definitely the way to go to make the bike more comfortable. So whether you're just cruising down the street, if you're doing jumps, or just want to make your bike more comfortable, pegs and the lower peg mounts are definitely something you need to invest in and get on your bike. I'd recommend picking up the whole package with the pegs, the peg mount, and the peg brace.
And I'm going to hook you guys up with a 15% off discount code using my name, Tyler Monagan, at checkout. I'll leave everything linked below in the description to Hemimoto to get your Surron upgraded. Once again, thank you to Hemimoto for sponsoring this video, and we'll get back into ripping the e-cart.
Have to take it on the road. We'll do a speed run down the road. I'm gonna put it in max power.
Based on my phone holding it, it didn't actually lock in the speed, but it said I did 70 miles an hour, 69.8. We're gonna call it 70. I have to order that 25 tooth, and I think we'll be there. Honestly, at 70 miles an hour, I don't really need to go or want to go any faster than that.
Looks like my options are 22 through 28, both the 22.
All right, so a few days later, we got the package in for the, should be, this small 21 tooth sprocket that I found. It should get us closer to that speed. Let's get this mounted up and see what it can do.
So we got the cart ready to go. It is about a week later. Look at the size difference. The 40 was the smallest I could get that would just mount onto this hub adapter, sprocket adapter, whatever you want to call it. This will just directly slide onto the axle, give us the max top speed. Can't go any smaller than this, so hopefully it works. So
swapping everything out is pretty easy. There's really not much to these carts.
All right, sprocket
should be ready to ride.
Sprocket is so small, it looks ridiculous.
Get this thing loaded up. I'm trying to outbeat the storm right now.
All right, you should be good to go. Thing barely fits in here. Grab one of my torque straps. These are the best tie downs you can get right now. They have this torque technology, which only gets tighter, so your straps can never come unhooked. It's your traditional ratchet strap or pull strap. Torque straps are the way to go. From moto straps to just strapping anything down in your truck or trailer, just pull it tight, locks in place, and the strap's not going anywhere. As always, I'll leave torque strap link below. Pick up a 2-pack for yourself, try them out. Definitely won't be disappointed. And you're probably gonna convert to all torque straps once you realize how good they are.
Well, it definitely doesn't look promising driving right into the storm.
All right, same deal. I'm gonna put it in medium.
See what we can get this thing up to.
Started to get like swerving, 82 miles an hour. Gonna start downpouring.
Coming down now. We got the cart loaded up. At least got a couple, 2-3 runs in before the road got wet. 82 miles an hour.
It's always something. Can never just go smooth. I wish I could have gotten a couple more runs. Chain already loosened up quite a bit too, so it's probably better off I didn't do a couple more runs. That chain came off at 80. It probably wouldn't be good. How much it already loosened up. There it is.
Whew. After those 3 runs, battery percentage wise, at 100 and dropped down to 93 for about 5 minutes of runtime.
Honestly, runtime then, if you wanted to go for 30, maybe 40 minutes, it would have plenty of charge. More than enough time to have fun for a while.
And this is the Chai battery system, 72 volt max, has 51 amp hours. So if you're trying to build a similar cart, Chai battery systems is the way to go. You can use my discount code to get 5% off your order. That'll also be linked below if you want to check them out. If you want to upgrade your Surron or build a sweet cart. And once again, thank you to ElectRO & Co. for the motor and control setup, which is under the tank right here. I'll leave them linked below too if you want to look into how to build a similar setup.
Well, I spoke too soon on the chain last night. Joe came by to test it out.
You probably said you tightened all the way.
No, it was tight. Yeah, she's done.
30 seconds in, the chain ripped off due to the amount of torque, probably because of the smaller sprocket and it pulling so hard compared to those bigger sprockets. So it's back to the drawing board. As you can see, the chain just got out of line. The motor's twisted in, then it completely sheared off the sprocket, so I'm waiting on one of those. Probably go back to my first idea, put the plate on, because this aluminum just isn't strong enough for how much torque this has. So I'll be back in a week or two with the next video on this thing. Like I said, if you guys are new, subscribe, throw a like in this video if you want to see more videos with the e-cart.
And if you want to see what's going down before I post the videos, you can follow my Instagram at Tyler Monagan. For now, I've been posting a lot of my Snapchat for the really behind the scenes stuff. But with that, give me some ideas on some different vehicles I could build with this electric platform. I know we can build some really cool stuff here soon.